Hello, everyone.
Hi.
Super happy to be in Australia, and I guess I'll take your questions now. Say something. Okay. You want to go to an ATM? I'll hook you up with some money. Yes, I did. I did turn on the traffic light screen so I could get here faster. It's a really handy ability. Will I be around for the next season? A lot of people have been asking me that. The answer is still the same. I don't know. So I can't tell you. Sorry, you guys, I'm gonna have to leave you hanging. I can't tell. Because that would ruin it, though, right? I mean, if you knew what was gonna happen, then you wouldn't watch it anymore, so.
It's been more serious, but when the writer's strike was on and you're working after it and all that, how does that mess with you and the fact the storyline has changed and all of that? What was the impact on you and the rest of the cast when that was going on?
Well, the writer's strike did kind of mess things up. It's like a big gap in your working schedule, so, I mean, it messed the whole season up, really. I mean, like everything kind of got messed up. Then the season was like cut in half, which was weird and everything. But for me, it's not so bad as for the rest of the cast and the crew, actually, because you know, it's not the way I pay my bills or anything like that. I still have school to do. So while the writer's strike was going on, I was just kind of chilling at home, doing my schoolwork, getting my grades up and everything like that. So it's really not so bad for me. But for the rest of the cast, the crew, you know, that's really bad because they're out of work for however long it went on for. So that was. I feel bad for some people because it's not just the cast that gets affected, it's the whole entire crew, so it's like, you know, that's kind of bad. But for me, it wasn't so bad, so.
Okay, stupid question, but if you could choose your superpower,
would
you choose
your name? If I could choose any superpower, I think it would be talking to animals, because that's kind of a weird power and it would be really fun. I think my dog and cat would have a lot to say. Or, if it wasn't that, I think it'd have to be like hero's power, traveling in time and space. Because that would be really handy. Wouldn't have to commute at all. You could just zap from one place to another. And I would have to go into the future and see what I was like 20 years from now. I would think that would be pretty cool. So those are my two choices. That's a good question. Schoolwork and acting are very tough things to manage. I think people forget a lot of times that child actors, you know, on top of like doing our jobs as actors and everything, we also have schoolwork to do. And when I'm not doing a show or anything, schoolwork is pretty tough on its own. So when I am like doing a show or in a movie or something like that, it's really, really tough because that means I have got to bring schoolwork on the set, and I've got to study for my tests and quizzes on the set, and I miss my tests and quizzes, which means I have to make them all on my back. Boring stuff, but very important because grades come first. So it's tough, but you know, I manage. So, but yeah, it's very, very tough. But the good thing is there's a lot of free time on the set. People think it's always like going, but yeah, glamorous and everything, but actually, filming a TV show is like 99% waiting, so that's good. That gives me some time to get the work done and everything. So.
I'm script about superheroes, so I was thinking that was pretty cool, first of all. And I was actually doing a guest appearance for Ghost Whisperer on my first audition for Heroes. And so it was kind of funny because I would think I was going to be able to audition for Heroes because I was doing Ghost Whisperer, and I was thinking, oh no, I'm going to be working in that time, so I can't shoot over the audition. But luckily, this is really lucky, the audition was on the same lot as the show Ghost Whisperer was filmed on. So as it happens, a really nice assistant, he took us over to the Heroes audition room when I was supposed to be getting changed for another scene on Ghost Whisperer. And I auditioned in like 10 minutes, and there was like no one else in the whole audition place auditioning for this role. And it was like the lights were dimmed and everything because I was like the last person there to audition. And ended up getting the part, so it was very lucky for me. And what I did to prepare was basically what I always do, just going over lines, making sure I know them really, really well. Memorization is a huge part of it. And then also after I know the lines really well, like always, me and my mom just kind of go over the lines and figure out the best way to do it and try to, you know, think like the character would be things like. And so that's pretty much that.
Do this. You're taking
taking me right after we filmed to get some of those healing shoes that roll. So she agreed to it, and that's definitely the most embarrassing thing. And you never will live something like that down either. Because they're repeats, you know? So my friends like see the show, and the next day I hear about it. So that was pretty bad.
I have a question. I just wanted to know if you have a girlfriend right now.
Thanks, Mom. No, single. So I'd have to be so right now, definitely. Yeah. Mom loves to embarrass me. In fact, if we're like walking the mall or something, she'll just go up to a group of girls, and she does this to all my brothers. She'll go up to a group of girls and say, "Hi, this is Noah. He was just thinking you guys were cute, and just wanted to say hi." So I'm actually pretty used to being embarrassed right now. I actually really don't get embarrassed, so yeah. Thanks, Mom. Well, I started out with music, like I said, and I did do concerts and everything when I was younger. I started doing concerts when I was 4, and I went to Jamaica when I was 5. And actually, I went to Australia when I was like 5 or 6 to play in the opera house. And so that's... So I started out with music, and I don't know, I'm a little bit rusty on the piano. I was trained classically, though, and I still do play the piano, but I also started to branch off with some like blues kind of jazzy stuff on the piano, which is really fun. I'm not trained in that, but it's just like improvisation kind of stuff. And then I'm also learning how to play the guitar right now, so those are like the two instruments that I'm really interested in. And yeah, you never know. I mean, it would be really awesome if I could start doing something with music. You know, I love music, and so it'd be really great if I could start doing something like that. You never know. I hope so.
I just
want to
ask,
I'm actually not a good person to ask about advice about how to become an actor or anything like that. But if I do have some advice, it's, well, besides always being humble and everything and not getting a big head about anything, it's just find something that you like and just work at it. Find something that you really like and you work at it. I mean, that's how I got into acting, you know, it's just playing the piano. I started when I was 4, I practiced, and by the time I was 6, it had given me all these other opportunities. So that's what I'd say. If you like to sing or something, then really work on that. Well, it's really great because the main show, is Heroes. And Heroes does have a huge fan base. It's kind of like a really like nice fan base, and especially the first season just picked up this huge following of fans. And it's really nice having a big fan base. You know, you see a lot of the same people at different events, conventions and things. And it feels good to know that you've got a group of people behind you when you're doing shows like this. So it's really nice to have that.
Yeah.
Pretty good out of you. My first ever convention on the side.
Yeah, I'm new with
it.
I don't know what thing this summer is.
And, I mean, that was pretty fun. Well, actually, it's kind of funny because the first time I went to that convention, it was on a bus with the rest of the cast. And so, during this, 4-hour long drive, the AC broke down. So it was a pretty long drive out there. But once we got there, it was pretty fun and everything. But it was really hectic because that was the first season of Heroes, and it was kind of like this big chaotic and fan gathering place. And so it was kind of like we went in and then we came out. We did the question and answer thing and then we came out. But I've also been to a convention in London, and that was really fun. That I kind of got to stay there a lot longer. It was kind of like this. And that was really, really great. You meet a lot of nice people at these conventions, and it's just really fun. It's really fun. And it's kind of interesting to see like the different people that come out in their different costumes. And in each country, it's a little bit different, so it's nice to get a feel for the place you're in.
Can you tell us a little bit about your lifestyles and your relationship with
them? Sure. On the show, Heroes is kind of a big ensemble cast, so, you know, everything. So I just like seeing Hayden all the time and all those guys all the time. It's actually like, no, not really. I actually see the people that I mostly work with are Ali Larder, and then on the second season, I think it was, I worked with Leonard Roberts a lot. And so those are mainly the two people that I work with. And they're really great. They were really, really nice. Leonard, you know, how far along are you guys? You, what?
Second season has a
second season? Wait, what season are you getting?
Third season.
Getting season 3 and season 4, so I'm gonna go ahead and. I'll just tell you this. I'll tell you this. Leonard Roberts. If you guys don't know this, then whatever. Leonard Roberts, he played with my dad, and it was really, really great working with him. He's a really funny guy. He's like a human jukebox. I mean, this guy knows like every single song that there is to know and all the lyrics to it. And he's so funny. I mean, he just made being on the set so much fun. So he was really, really great to work with. And then Ali Larder, she's a great actress too. She helped me out a lot with my acting and everything like that, gave me some really helpful tips, and she's super nice too. And I think it's been great overall. And then I get to see the other cast, like Helen, these press conventions and things like that, and then award ceremonies. So, I mean, I do get to see them a lot. They're all really great. Milo and Paige and all those guys, they're really, really nice. So it's a fun experience, definitely. None of them are mean, so that makes it nice.
You have a favorite?
I have a favorite. Yeah, I think Leonard Roberts would probably be my favorite person to work with. He is really, really fun. Greg Grunberg, I haven't gotten to work with a lot, but he's also another really, really funny guy, so they're all really nice though. Flying to different countries. I do like traveling a lot. That's one of my favorite things to do, just because you get to kind of go and see like the different wildlife of each country and the different people of each country. But the flying itself, when I was little, it was fun. And I was like, yeah, I'm up in an airplane, yeah, I'm looking out the window, it's in city or whatever. But it was like a 14 or 16 hour flight from LA and California out to here. That was a little bit too long for me. But flying's not so bad. My mom, though, she has a problem flying. She kind of like breaks my arm every time we take off. So I try to get her to sleep before we actually take off. Because if she isn't, then it's bad. But I like flying.
Wow.
Wow. Well, this is something nice about my character. My character doesn't shoot fireballs or electricity out of his hands or anything like that. It's disappointing for me, because I'd like to shoot fireballs out of his hands, but whatever. But he pretty much just works with electrical machinery. And one of the nice things about that is that, you know, there's not all this, like, imagining that, you know, something's coming out of your hand or something like that. All I have to do is, like, touch a machine, and they freaked it out, so it wouldn't really do what was supposed to happen. So there's like no special effects when it comes to me, you know what I mean? It's like on the set, you know, during the scene, my powers are real, so it's pretty nice. I think the only special effects kind of thing I did was there was one episode where I was supposed to get hit like cross 10 feet or something like that. And so in rehearsal, they strapped me up with a harness and put like, this giant stunt pack on me. This guy just kind of yanked me. And there was a pulley system up in the trees, and I just kind of flew like 10 feet back onto this path. It was kind of scary because I was going fast, but it was really fun too. The best thing about going out to conventions, I mean, is definitely like meeting all the new people. The convention I went to in London was really nice. I actually stayed in contact with some people from that event, and then the people here were really nice as well. So it's kind of like the same thing, just meet such nice people, and it's a really great time. You know, it's awesome. Okay. Out of all the costumes, what was it? Yeah, there are some crazy costumes. But my favorite one is the Jawa outfit. Okay, Kelly has that one on. She's the little Jawa. If you've seen this, like, you know the Jawa from Star Wars, right? The guy, yeah. If you've seen one of those running around, I think that's the best ever. It's kind of scary, but it's good. I would definitely dress up as a Jedi. I mean, come on. That's what I did when I was little. Probably my mom made me an awesome Jedi outfit. Probably wouldn't fit into it anymore. But that was fun. I did that when I was like 8 or something. So I would definitely have to dress up as a Jedi. I even have crazy lightsabers if you really want to. So I mean, it would be cool. You know, I can have that.
Can you just repeat my question in case no one can hear it?
Well, no fairness to me. Unfortunately, I don't really watch a lot of TV, so I'm not familiar with a lot of things that are out there. But I, you know, we don't have a lot of time to watch TV. It's kind of busy right now. I'm in my junior year of high school, and that's hard. So there's a lot of like homework and studying. I just have midterms here, which means I gotta make up my midterm and like at home, and all this boring school stuff keeps me really busy. So I don't have a lot of time to watch TV. And when I do watch TV, it's mainly like on the DVDs. Like I watched one show that I watched on DVD, which I haven't finished yet. So if you guys know the ending, please don't yell it out, because I don't know what's gonna happen. But it's Battlestar Galactica. And that one is really good.
Is the rest of your family
good?
Do you think you're the second youngest? So is anyone else in the industry?
No one else in my family acts. No one does. No one seems to want to. So I'm the only one right now. We all play musical instruments, though. So my older brother plays the cello and the bass guitar, so the same thing. My sister, she plays the violin, and then my oldest brother, he plays the violin and the viola, and then my mom and dad play the piano.
What do you want to do with
When I grew up, a lot of people think that I like want to be an actor my whole life, because I'm a singer, but I actually don't, so that's a good question. When I grew older, I think I would want to do something with animals, funny enough. My whole life, I've kind of been like a wildlife person, a person, so definitely don't. I wouldn't be able to think of living in a city, so that's a question. But my whole life, I've really liked animals. I've always had pets. And, you know, when I was little, you know, I was like, I want to do something with animals, but, you know, all of the kids kind of want to be like a veterinarian or something like that. But as I've gotten older, it's kind of stayed with me, so that's what I want to do, something like biology or something with animals. So. I really wasn't watching Heroes at the time when my character was being like reintroduced as the Rebel character. I wasn't actually watching the show, so but I did like catch up on the show with the DVDs and everything. So it's kind of cool to see my character like, you know, helping all these people in different areas trying to get through stuff, even though I wasn't like involved physically on the show. But then when I came back for those two episodes, it was really, really interesting, because it was kind of fun. It was fun to see everyone again. I hadn't been on in a while, so it was like really, really fun to come back. And it was like, you're here again, yay! So it was really fun. Around the city and everything. I've only been here since like Thursday, and I've been doing this since yesterday, and then I've been doing this all today. But I did get to go around the city a little bit. I went to St. Patrick's Cathedral, which was really, really cool, very beautiful and everything. And my mom and I walked up the Fitzroy Gardens, am I saying that right? Fitzroy Gardens. And that was really beautiful too. And so I have gotten to look around city a little bit. We like public transportation here. It's very, very handy. Because in LA, it's not like that. So it's nice to be able to jump on and go somewhere. And we went to the museum, which is nice. And then we're planning on going soon over to Phillip Island to go see penguins and go see some kangaroos, koalas, and be cool like that.
Attention Armageddon attendees. Those of you who are waiting for the robot chicken signing, please be aware that it's one robot chicken item only. It's one robot chicken item only. If you do not have an item, there are cards available at the signing desk, which you will receive when you make way there. Thank you.
I'm a teacher, so I'm going to hassle you about the school stuff. What do you do well in at school?
What do you mean, what do I do well in?
Like, what subjects?
What subjects do I like? Subjects do I do well in?
Well,
grades come first, you know, always. So, I do well with pretty much everything. I like chemistry, which is actually my worst grade, so it's kind of funny. But I do well in everything, which I'm very proud of, because, thank you. It's the hardest part of my job, to tell you the truth. You know, acting is like, you know, it's hard, you have to memorize the lines and everything, but schoolwork is really what takes the daily grind. You know, just every single day doing your homework and studying, so that's the most important thing. So, yeah, but chemistry is cool. I'm taking calculus this year, which is not so cool. No, that's not cool at all. But I do like chemistry, and yeah, I had biology last year. That was fun too. So I like the sciences overall pretty much. Get to light stuff on fire and stuff. So I think that's cool.
What's your favorite color?
My favorite color. I think I've inherited this from my mom, because like she wears clothes this color all the time, black. I know it's depressing, it's like the absence of color or whatever, but black is nice. I mean, it goes with anything. You know, you can wear black all the time. Just so long as you're not like completely covered in black. Then like, a little creepy.
Are you getting recognized on the streets yet?
Am I getting recognized? Yeah, sometimes I do. It's not like all the time constantly, but yeah, the thing I get most is, you know, you look familiar to me. Like, that's weird. Then people will be like, you know who you look like? I finally figured out. You look like that kid from Heroes. And I'll be like, yeah, I get that a lot. That's weird. And no, I tell them a lot of times, because I think if they like the show, that would be kind of messed up to just be like, oh yeah, I'm not that kid. So I'm like, yeah, actually I am. But people are like, ah, no, you're joking, you're not really. I'm like, okay. They're like, wait a minute, are you really? I'm like, yeah, I really am. And so then they freak out a little bit.
I've got two questions for you. You
are
very well spoken.
13. Yeah, 13.
Oh, wow. I've got a 14-year-old girl, and I can't imagine standing on the stage and speaking the same way as
me. Thank you for your...
Did you get tutored to do that?
No. My sister taught me how to bow, though. So, when I was little, because I started out playing the piano, and so she thought it was an important thing for me to be able to bow. So she taught me how to bow. Hey, what? Show us about? Yes, thank you. And no, basically it's just my mom and my dad talking a lot. I mean, I started very young age, kind of like speaking, you know. And funny enough, it's a lot easier to speak in front of a big crowd than in front of a small group of people, I think. Because like a big crowd, it's kind of like you got in there, you know, it's fine. But when it gets to like a little group, it's different, you know. So yeah, I guess I've just been doing it for a while. I started acting when I was 6 years old, so it's been a long time. I think it'd be cool to play bad guy, honestly, because, you know, it seems that, you know, I'm always like the little kid or like the, you know, good guy. But I think it'd be cool to be a bad guy, personally, be all evil and everything. Besides, bad guys are always cooler, you know what I mean? The good guys are always kind of like the ones that you're behind and you want them to do well and everything, but the bad guys are always the coolest, so I want to be a bad guy personally.
Okay, a couple of years ago, some of us saw one of the boys from Harry Potter.
What?
One of the boys from Harry Potter. And so with his mother in the room, somebody asked, does he keep his bedroom clean? Because your mum's here to keep you honest.
My bedroom's really clean. I clean it every day and vacuum it. It's really nice. Yeah, you know that Febreze stuff? I use that all the time. I'm like compulsive about that. And my mom's a little crazy right now though. She's moves up. She had to take some NyQuil for a cold, so. No, well, you know, I'm a 13-year-old boy. I'm allowed to keep my room a little bit messy, right? A little.
Do you have Facebook?
Yes, I do. What? Yeah, I mean, why not? Sure, you guys can add me. This is a hard life. No, this is... If there were some places in Australia that I'd like to see in particular. Well, I did come to Australia once before when I was six, like I said, 5 or 6 or something. And I did actually see Sydney, and I got to travel around Australia a lot. So I think I've probably seen a lot of Australia now that I'm in Melbourne, or I've been to Sydney and everything. And I'm not that familiar with like, what's where, but I definitely do want to do some more traveling and get to see a lot more of like the wildlife nature of the place. So, I mean, like I said, you can go to the profile and see penguins breeding and everything like that, but do you have any suggestions? I didn't get to snorkel because I had to use my water wings or something. Well, that's true. I think I was there, but yeah, I would like to go around Australia a little more though, now that I'm older, because last time I went, I couldn't really do a lot of stuff. My older brothers went with me too, and they got to like snorkel and looking cool like that, and I was left on the beach. But I would like to do some more traveling here. No, I don't think I have any celebrity crushes. Beyonce. Yeah, Beyonce and I, we hang out on the weekend too. Besides that, you would not believe how many Tim Tams I've eaten. No, seriously, your mind would explode if you knew how many I've eaten. I got sick yesterday. My mom was like, do you want to order in room service? Do you want to order a little dessert? I was like, no. If I have anything else, I will die. Literally, I will die. I've had like whole packages. I even have resorted to stealing them. Like, just stealing them from different people. So it's bad. My mom's gotten vicious too. I had one left yesterday. And while I was signing autographs, she stole it. She stole it in bites too. She would take one bite and put it back. And I'd look on it. And by the end of the day, it was just gone. So I'm disappointed in her.
You know what? I'd like to welcome you to Australia.
Oh, sorry, what?
I'd like to welcome you to Australia.
Oh, thank you very much. What did he say?
Those Tim Tams are pretty good, aren't they?
Oh, yeah, they are. I've been introduced to, like, all the different kinds of flavors and everything. They're good.
Actually, I have two questions. First one is, have you ever tried Tim Tams Land?
A what?
Tim Tams Land.
Oh, I don't think so. Is that where you bite it? Each end and then it's stuck in the middle?
Yep,
oh, yeah.
It.
The origins of Tim Tam, I'm like that. Yeah,
okay,
definitely.
Good.
I actually spilled some milk on my shirt the other day trying that, but it's all right now. I've got it now. Okay, well, the funny moment that comes to mind is Dana Davis, who played my cousin on the show. She, I don't know, she was in a funny mood or something one of these days. And so I had this sweater on, and she asked if she could borrow my sweater. So I was like, obviously, I'm gonna borrow my sweater. So I give her my sweatshirt or whatever, and she wanders over to the craft table service area, and she's just like, okay, I'm just looking at the food they have and everything, and I didn't really think anything of it. And so then after a while, she gives my sweatshirt back to me, and I was like, okay. So I go to put my hands in my pockets because I walk around with this lock, and she put like tea cakes in my pockets. So my pockets were like stuffed with tea cakes, and I put my hands in, it was just terrible. Not good. So I think I ended up putting peanut butter on her trailer door, and so I got her back. I think that was the best moment. She was really fun. She and I would actually kind of get in trouble sometimes because, you know, the director and all those guys, they wanted to be serious and everything. We'd be playing with, like, I don't know, Hot Wheels or something like that. So she was really fun, but that was good times. What?
Have you tried Vegemite?
I've heard about Vegemite, and I saw some Vegemite, and it's really good. I don't trust you. I saw some. It kind of looked like tar in a box, and I heard that you guys think it's really good, but I don't know if I'm that. If someone were to give me some right now, I would eat it, but unless...
Do you
play any sports? Well, like I said, I was a junior in high school, but you guys have a different system here, so I'd be like 11th grade, and that's like 2 or 3 years younger than people my grade, so they're all like 16, almost like 17, and so I can just imagine myself out on the football field, you know? A bunch of like 16 and 17 year olds who are like 6'4" is running at me, I don't think it would turn out well for me. So I think I'm gonna wait until next year when I'm like 14 and then maybe, you know, try it then. But for now, I think I want to live. So I'll still, I guess. I did do fencing though for a little while, which was fun, you know. I was like part of the sword movement, so that was fun. But other than that, besides, I'm really busy. And if I was to like join a sport or something, I wouldn't be able to do stuff like this, because, you know, that would be kind of like walking out on the team or whatever. But I have started taekwondo, which is pretty fun. I've taken photos for that. It's pretty awesome. I got punched by my instructor in the chest. It hurt a lot, but it's okay. It's okay. Was it? What's my favorite what? I didn't really hear the first question, sorry.
What's your favorite food?
Food. Spaghetti, definitely. I mean, I know it's a classic or whatever, but I like pasta. Actually, like, that. I eat a lot of pasta, honestly, I do. And penne pasta, spaghetti, angel hair. Do I what? Oh, yeah, I know. I have a lot of carbs. But, you know, I'm still young, so... I figure if I eat like 3 pounds of spaghetti, it'll catch up to me someday, but I'm good for now. I'm pretty comfortable with that. My grandmother actually remarks on how much spaghetti I can eat in one sitting. And it is amazing. Every time I go to my grandmother's house and she makes me spaghetti, I'll eat like all of it. And she makes like, you know, 3.5 pounds of spaghetti, so, you know, I put that down.
Now, what do you prefer to do?
You know, I always thought that I'd like to do drama because it's like more serious and you get to kind of think about what your character's thinking about and it's not so like, I don't know, like irrational or whatever. But I've done drama for a while and I think I'd like to go back to comedy because, I don't know, it's just kind of, it seems like a more relaxed vibe than drama. Drama a lot of times is very stressful. So I think I would like to go back to comedy for a while and see how it goes.
Cheese.
Last
question.
Okay.
No.